without your Holy Spirit. And so this afternoon, as I humble myself and ask forgiveness for all my sins, will you wash me clean with your blood? And I pray, Father, that you pour your Spirit upon your people. In Christ's name we pray.
Amen.
Let's open the Bible and listen to what the Spirit of God has to say. Let's go to the Old Testament. Come with me to the book of Numbers. Let's look at Numbers chapter 15 and verse 37. And the Lord spake unto Moses. This is not an ordinary human being speaking to another human being. This is God. And when God speaks, there is power. And when God speaks, there is creation. And when the voice of God is heard, there is recreation. There is never a time when you listen to the word of God and you will go home the same, because God's power has the power to create you and to recreate you.
Amen.
This afternoon is not going to be an exception. God spake unto Moses, saying, speak unto the children of Israel, listen to this, young people, and bid them that they make them, please read this word for me. What is this?
Fringes.
Not French fries. Fringes. Fringes in the borders of their garments throughout their generations. Did you know that God is a fashion designer? Do you know God wants you to wear the latest outfit? Amen. Who told you that God is not a tailor? God is an outdated, old, you know, something like that. Let's listen to what God has to say. He says, tell my people in Microtel that they have to make in their garments fringes throughout their generations. I would like to know, is there anyone here who is wearing fringes? I want you to raise your hand. Is there anyone here who is wearing fringes? I will be very happy if you could raise your hand. I see boys checking. You don't have to check about the dress. I'm asking individual questions. Is there someone who is wearing fringes? Do you know what is the meaning of fringes? In other words, it's a simple definition. What is fringes?
Tassels.
Who said tassels?
Money.
Who told you she's outdated? She's in style. The Bible says, fringes. Do you know, friends, what is the meaning of fringes? Tassels. God gave a specific dress for his people. And that is, every time you see my people, tell them that they are supposed to make fringes in the border. For how long? Okay. What kind of a color did God recommend? Do you know what is God's favorite color? Let's go to the Bible. You think I'm a stupid to wear blue and come to me? I listen to God. Why do you think Eloy came in blue today? Mrs. Cibrian came in blue. You know why? Accident. Every time you look at the fringes in the border that they put upon the fringe of the borders, a ribbon of what is the color? God's assignment to Moses, tell my people to wear blue color tassel. Why blue? Why not orange? Why not yellow or purple? I'm going to show you. the significance of color in the Bible. The Bible is clear, fringes of blue. Let's look at the Bible. I'm not sure how many of you have really seen. This is how the Jews really wore their dress. You need to understand the Bible is written in the context of the Hebrew culture. It is written against the Middle East Palestine culture. So it is the Jew. Do you know how the Jews dress? Yes. Have you seen? What do they wear? Let me just see. Every corner of their dress till today has to be tasseled. And it has to be in blue. What you're seeing here is from the Bible. Why did God tell them? Let's go to the Bible. Deuteronomy 22:12. You shall make yourself twisted threads on the four corners. How many corners are supposed to be there when you wear a dress? The Bible says, young people, don't forget this principle. Four corners. Do you know why did God give garments for you and me? Many young people have forgotten. To cover yourself. If you are wearing a dress, and if that dress is not covering you, you need to go back to your dormitories, change your dress, come back to the house of God. Will you say amen?
Amen.
The pastor is not saying this. The Bible says that. I want you to memorize this. Take a printout, A4, Times New Roman, bold, underline, paste it on your locker. Four corners of the garment to cover yourself. I'm going to take some more deeper. A ribbon of blue. Let me just ask you two questions. What is the design? What is the design? Fringe. What is the color? What is the significance of color blue in the Bible? When you see blue color in the Bible, what does it signify? That's why I wore blue, so that you will see blue.
Loyalty.
No, that's the worldly interpretation. Shall we all give her a hand? Let's give her a hand. God bless you. You get 1,000 pesos gift. That is Dr. Chen. You meet it right off the bat. Let's go to the Bible. You will not understand why God gave this. And it shall be unto you, please read it with me, for a fringe. Do you know why did God give fringe? Do you know why did God give blue color? That? Come on, read it. Ye may look upon it and remember all the commandments. God gave blue color. So every time you look at blue color, you will remember. Not the sky. Not the ocean. You will remember. All the commandments of the Lord. We want to go very deep this. Don't you ever think that these kind of meetings are a joke. The Bible says, you look upon the fringe. Number two, I want you to identify all the verbs. Identify the verbs here. Look. What is the next verb? Remember. Two more. Do. And then. Seek not after your own heart. If you look at anybody's dress, if that dress is not leading you to God, in Jesus' name, burn that dress or you donate that dress to Tacloban typhoon victims. Not for grown-up, but for kids. The Bible is clear. Let's look at all the four words. Repeat after me. Don't change the Bible. One more time. Look, remember, do, see. Now, how many of you have seen a Jew with his dress? Yes or no? Okay. Now, Ron, can you please come? Let's pretend that he's going to be a Jew. Jew. I want you to see how many corners does he have. Please come. Wrong way, please come. One, two, three, four. Show the tassel.
What is the color of the tassel?
God gave this dress exclusively for the Jews. We will come to that later. I will show you. Because the women were allowed only to a certain part of the temple. And men were allowed to serve. Do you know where did the women and children sit in the temple courts? Which part? The courtyard. But men were allowed a little inside. There is a reason for it. Now I want you to know, every time a Jew would pass by, every time they saw the Jew, they saw the four corners, they saw the twisted tassel, they saw the blue fringe. Throughout their generation, the young people would say, "Daddy, what are you wearing that? Isn't that very, very interesting?" And then they have to call the children and say, "God gave 10 commandments." Thank you. Appreciate it. Please don't take it. There is an interesting concept. Commandments. This afternoon we are going to study about God's holy commandments. Let's go to the Bible. Do you know what is the Hebrew word for this tassel? You can write it down. Tzitzit. Where are the Hebrew students? It's called, it's a sari. Sari. Tzitzit. Okay, Hebrew students? Are you with me? Theology? So tzitzit means that's the tassel of the fringe. Now every time you see a Jew who is dead, he has to be wrapped in the same. And once you wrap him, you have to bury him. But I want you to know, a Jew is always buried with the cloth wrapped around with one exception. When they bury him under the ground, do you know what do they cover? What do they cut? What do you think they cut before they bury him? They cut the tassel. You know why? Once a person dies, he is no more under the law. If there is an empty seat next to you, will you raise your hand? Okay, please come walking right here. If there is an empty seat right next to you. Okay, thank you, thank you. Let's go. Now, every time you see Jewish burial, you go to Israel, you always see hundreds of Palestinians, you know, bombing Israel. And you will see hundreds of Israeli soldiers also attacking the others. But every time you see, their body always comes wrapped in this cloth. Because you have to understand, the Bible is Jewish. The Bible was written in a Jewish background. Whether you like it or not, Jesus was Jewish. He was born Jewish. He lived Jewish, he died Jewish, and he was buried Jewish, and he was resurrected Jewish. Whether you like it or not, Jesus is a Jew. Jesus has a Jewish passport, whether you like it or not. And his nationality is Jew, whether you like it or not. I am an Indian. That is by fact. Jesus is a Jew. But you have to understand how Jesus transcends beyond the Jewish culture, because we are going to go into a deeper part of how this dress affected even Jesus Christ. Let's go to the Bible. There was a prophet by the name Samuel. Do you know what was the name of this arrogant and disobedient king who disobeyed God? And he went and caught hold of the mantle. Let's go to the Bible. Samuel turned about to go away. He laid hold upon the skirts of his mantle and it rent. Samuel said unto him, the Lord hath rent the kingdom of Israel from thee this day. Do you remember the story of Samuel and Saul? He tried to hold on to his mantle that was nothing but his dress. Let's go to the other one. Do you remember the story of David and Saul? How many of you remember the story? He was hiding inside the cave, and as he was sleeping, David quietly slipped inside and he cut the edge. What do you think he cut? What do you think he cut? Now you are biblically informed students, so you should know what he cut. Let's go to the other one. Elijah heard. He wrapped his face in the mantle, went out, stood in the entering of the cave. There came a voice, what doest thou here, Elijah? The Bible also talks upon how Elijah passed and he cast his mantle. This is nothing but the dress. Let's go a little bit here. He took up the mantle that fell from him. Do you remember when he went up to heaven, what fell down? The same dress. Now, let me see how intelligent you are. Are you reminded of another story in the New Testament about the mantle? In the New Testament. Thank you. You're all intelligent Bible students. Let's go to the Bible. Behold, a woman that was diseased with an issue of blood 12 years. Many people know this, but most people don't know what she touched. Today, you have come here to touch someone whose name is called Jesus. And the reason why many of you have not been healed is that when was the last time you started touching the law of God? You touch God's law, you will instantly be healed, because the law is the transcript of God's character. Let's go to the Bible. A woman, deceased, came behind and she touched. This is where most of us get our theology wrong. She didn't touch the garment. She touched the hem of his garment. Why do you think she touched the hem of the garment? She said, if I may but touch his garment, I shall be whole. Because it was only men who wore. The reason for it. Jesus turned about, and when he saw her, he said, daughter, be of comfort, thy faith has made thee whole. And the woman was made whole from that hour. Symbolically, if you want to say, who does woman represent? The church. If you want healing, touch God and stop keeping his commandments. You will be made whole instantly. You're having a problem with your business. That's because some of you have not been sincere in paying your tithes. You're having a problem with some issue. That's because there is a certain sin in me. Let's try to see here. She came behind and touched. I like what Luke says. Each gospel writer says differently. He says, border of the garment. One says hem of the garment. Another one says border. Do you know Jesus was wearing this And every time he went to the synagogue, he covered his head and started reading. You go and read Luke chapter 4. Remember, Jesus, as his custom was, went every Sabbath after Sabbath. Let's go look at the Bible. So this woman is about to touch the tzitzit. She's going to touch the hem, touch the garment. When the men of the place had knowledge, please, many people don't know that there is a verse like this in the Bible. They sent out into all the country round about and brought unto him all that were diseased. Listen to this. I know you have been reading your Bible for many times, for many years, but do you know this? And besought him that they might touch only the hem of his garment. Most of the Christians know only that one woman touched the hem. No. Whole world touched Jesus' garment. And as many as touched were made perfectly whole. I want to read this one more time. Are you excited?
Yes.
I'm more excited. Besought him that they might only touch the hem of his garment. Is that so? Who is the writer? Matthew was writing to the Jews. Who was writing to the Gentiles? Wait a minute. Many people don't understand why we need to preach the gospel in every city and town. Let's go to the Bible. Whithersoever he entered into village or city, look here, village, city, country, they laid the sick in the street. They did not go to the hospital. They put them in the streets and besought him that they will touch the border of his garment, and as many as touched him were made whole. Amen?
Amen.
Don't you ever think that you and I are ordinary people? Every time we go to a village, when people touch us, they should be healed. How many of you can say, when people touch me, they are healed? Once I started my ministry, there was a man who was very, very serious. They said, Pastor, will you please come and pray? I went, I prayed, I went up, I did not even reach home. The man died. It was very embarrassing for me. Very embarrassing. I just thought, it hit me very hard. Maybe those people thought if we had not told this pastor, this man would have survived. I knelt down and I asked God to touch me. My life has never been the same till then. Don't ever go to pray for someone who is sick with sin in your life. If you have sin in your life, you better say, I will pray for you from home. Sometimes God can use us so mightily to teach others the lesson, the impact and the terribleness of sin. You've got to be very careful, especially when in Indian setup, we used to cast demons. When we stop preaching like this, in Philippines, I'm not afraid. I've not come across any demon-possessed woman. In India, the moment you stop preaching, you will have at least 15 or 20 demon-possessed ladies jumping up, red eye, staring at you. And if you're not careful, they will tell your secret sinful life. I'm not sure. Many times, I'm not afraid of men, I'm afraid of women, because they prophesy about you correctly. These are false prophets, but prophesy truly, because it's only the devil who knows the other devil and the sins. Are you getting the point? Now let's go to the Bible. I'm going to show you another thing. Moses turned. Went down from the mount, and the two tables of the testimony were in his hand. How many tables of testimony?
Two.
Now this is where most of the confusion is. Have you seen the Ten Commandments written right this side and this side? Right?
Yes.
Look at the Bible. The tables were written on both their sides. How many sides? How many sides? It doesn't say two sides. Both. We're going to study a little more deeper. On the one side and on the other, they were written. Now the question is, who wrote it? The tables were the work of God, and the writing was the writing of God graven upon the tables. There are three things I want to stress. What was it written on? Tables. Whose work? What did God use to write? What did God use? The implication, the writing of God. God used what? Now, this evening's Bible study is a little bit very intense and very in-depth. Now, let's see what's happening here. Here is God who literally carved out the Ten Commandments. Do you know Moses didn't do anything? How many times were the Ten Commandments written by God?
Once.
Be careful when you answer. How many times were the Ten Commandments written by God?
Once.
How many times did Moses go to receive the Ten Commandments?
Two times.
Who wrote the Ten Commandments the second time?
Moses.
Okay. I will be very happy if you don't give your opinions, suggestions. Are you sure? Before we do that, I'm going to call for someone to give us a special number. Praise God. We will listen to a special number by our good friend. Later, we will just go ahead with some more. Let's go here. It came to pass as soon as he came nigh unto the camp, he saw the calf and the dancing, and Moses' anger waxed hot, and he cast. Look here, my friends. This was called out by God, and he cast the tables out of his hands, and he broke them beneath the bar. Now, what am I trying to say? Watch this. One. Here is Aaron, another leader, a weak leader. A leader can never be weak, because instead of he leading people to God, he allowed the people to lead him. You know what did he do? He took the calf which they had made. Moses burned it in the fire. He ground it to powder. He strode it upon the water, and he made the children of Israel drink like Coca-Cola. Literally, they drank the calf. You have to be very careful when you cherish a sin. That sin that you like the most. Imagine, sometimes we love money. Just imagine God is giving you like $1 million. He's putting it in a blender. And he puts a little bit of calamansi and honey. He says, drink it. You want to be, and then you drink it, you become a millionaire. I will tell you why God had to do that. There is a reason. The Lord said unto Moses, This time, hey, my friend, don't expect me to carve the tables. I called you the first time you came up to the mountaintop. I carved out the tables and gave you, but you cast it down and you broke it. Now this is episode 2. Welcome to episode 2 of the Ten Commandments. He says, okay, Lord. Hew thee two tables of stone. This is where we have to get our English correct. What is the figure of speech? What is the figure of speech? English majors. Simple. Jessa, very proud of you. You speak like William Shakespeare. But you are not Shakespeare. Okay. Like, you have to be very careful when you get this. The second one was like unto the first, but it is not like the first. Are you getting the point? This mic looks like the mic that Obama speaks in White House. This podium looks like Obama. And I might look the point is simple. And I will write upon these tables the words that were in the first tables which thou breakest. Who is writing the Ten Commandments?
God.
Do you know why? The moment God allows human beings to write the Ten Commandments, he knows what will they write. The reason why we are having trouble in today's Christianity is because we have taken the liberty, and I'm going to show the difference between how God wrote and how human beings wrote. Let's go to the Bible. Let me make this clear. Tables of stone like unto the first. Now the question is, does anybody know on what tables of stone were the Ten Commandments written? You know your Bibles very well. Go to the chapter where God told them, I'm going to meet you. Come on. Because the Ten Commandments had to be written on some kind of a material. Beg your pardon?
Sycamore.
Okay. I like your participation, though your answer is wrong. I like your spirit. Okay, let's go here. Let's try to find out. Now I'm going to show you, in the Bible times, God gave special dresses for the priests. Did you know that? You go to any Catholic institution, you will find the priest wearing peculiar, specific dress. But looking at an Adventist pastor, can you say this is a pastor? Can you?
No.
Because he comes like what? He comes like Bill Gates CEO, something like that, right? Dressed. But in the Bible times, God gave a specific, beautiful, peculiar dress. Look at this. God says, you will make what kind of garments? Even the garments looked very holy for the priest. But these days even priests don't look holy. Okay. For Aaron thy brother, for God gave holy garments for two reasons. Number one, for
glory.
The other one, for beauty. I always wish that our church will give pastors good dress so that the moment you say, you know, hey, this is my pastor. Correct? Very difficult to say because most of the pastors dress like football coaches. Okay, now let's go to the Bible. God says in Psalm 132, verse 16, I will also clothe a priest with salvation. Now don't get me wrong. Let's go quickly. What are the different colors God gave for the priest to wear. Number one, tell me.
Gold.
Blue. Purple. Scarlet. And then always you should wear fine linen inside. Because every time a priest went to the holy place or the most holy place, he was always sweating. It was only the fine linen that prevented him from sweating. So every priest must wear fine linen, like inside and undergarments. Now, apart from that, God gave beautiful four colors. Don't miss it. If you miss it, you will miss a very deep theology. What are the four colors? Gold, blue, purple, scarlet. One more time. What are the four colors?
Gold,
blue, purple, scarlet. Now, God also gave them a robe of ephod. You know what is an ephod? What the high priest wore. This is not only the garment. This is an ephod. And you will make the robe of the ephod what color?
Blue.
What does blue represent? What does blue represent? Now let's go a little deeper. Again, the Bible says, you take gold, blue, purple, scarlet. Even in the middle of the night, if they ask the four colors, you should say. Let's repeat one more time.
Gold, blue, purple, scarlet.
Don't fight. Because in just a short while, you're going to see one color is going to miss. I'm going to show you what. God says, these are the garments which they shall make, a breastplate, and an ephod, and a robe. First, you learn only about the dress. Now, the breastplate, ephod, robe of all blue. Every time they looked at the pastor, they looked at the priest, what are you supposed to be reminded of? The law of God. These days, when you look at the pastor, are you able to see the law of God? Please don't say it loudly. Because there is only one pastor here. Okay. Oh, you're telling about your church pastor. Okay, I agree. There shall be a hole in the top of it, in the midst thereof. It shall have a binding of woven work round about the whole, as it were the whole of an habergeon, that it be not rent. Look at this. Now we are going to talk about pomegranate and God. Do you know every time the priest, the high priest, went into the place, they had to wear this bell and pomegranate? Why? Not when they are tied, they just pick up the pomegranate and no. God had a reason. Upon the hem of it thou shalt make pomegranates. You know what was the color of the pomegranate? Blue. Pomegranates of?
Blue.
Purple. Scarlet. What are the four colors? And the bells of gold between them round about, a golden bell and a pomegranate. For example, there should be a golden bell, a pomegranate. Golden bell, a pomegranate. It should be upon the hem of the robe round about. You know why? Every time the priest walked, you could hear the beautiful bell. Right? Just imagine, many bells around the robe, and then he had pomegranate. What are the colors?
Blue,
purple, scarlet. Now you will be very sure. And it shall be upon Aaron to minister, and his sound shall be heard when he goeth into the holy place before the Lord, and when he cometh out, that he die not. Every time a pastor is ministering in the church, the pastor must be able to minister the law of God. And people should hear God's law coming out of the pastor's mouth. Don't go to any meeting where they will entertain you, where they will inform you, where they will preach anything except the law of God. If that is the case, when was the last time you heard? Gold, blue, purple, scarlet. Let's go to Revelation 17, everybody. Now we are going to do some mathematics. Revelation 17 talks about what woman? Can you tell me? What woman? Revelation 12 talks about? Remember, you have to study the Bible. We are living in the last days. Revelation, yes. Oh, come on. The woman was arrayed. Come on, tell me all the colors.
Purple,
scarlet, gold. One color is missing.
Blue.
In the last days, there is a church. And it's a hall. What is missing? What is negated? What is deleted? The law of God. Having a golden cup in her hand, full of abominations and filthiness of her fornication. There are only two churches. Not Pentecost, not Methodist, not IMC. There are only two churches. What is the first one? What do you call this church? Church of God? Who said Church of God? I want to, Dr. Jim, do they have a Baptist church? I want to baptize you right now. That's the true church. Praise God. Robe, and they had a embroidered cloth. You know, it's very interesting. I have some presentations right here, and I can take you for about 7 to 8 hours. Still life, and you will never leave this place. Such is the glory and the beauty of God's amazing world. This gift. I want you to look at High Priest, who is right now interceding, who appears to be the bread of life, and he's the one who offers incense. And every time you see him offer prayer, you see spark. This evening we are going to have some prayer spark. I want to invite at least two groups to come and sing. If you are impressed by the Holy Spirit, AUB students, who wants to be the first group to come forward and sing? We are going to have some praise and worship, and we are going to have some sessions of prayer, and then we will enter into second session of Bible study. Are we ready?
Gracias.
Dasmaji who would like to sing a song. Somebody from Dasmaji.
Okay, before we listen to our dear mother as he sings, I invite for our next song, we will all be singing. So I invite all of you to open your Bibles to Psalm 119:11. The book of Psalms, chapter 119, verse 11. So you'll be seeing this.
Where is Mr. Sam? This is how Elijah was raptured to heaven. I'm told that this is his birthday today. So we won't have it. I was praying to the Lord earnestly, Lord, we need some sponsors for tonight's pizza. God answers our prayers mysteriously. What do you say?
Amen.
Amen only to those who want pizza, right? Is he here? If he's here, do you want to pray? Okay, we want to recognize the various people here. Das Maji Church, stand up. We would like to look at you. If you're from, shall we all give them a hand? Praise the Lord. Putting Kaho Church, please stand up. Ellen June, stand up. Praise the Lord. Okay. AUP students, stand up. Want to see you. AUP students, praise the Lord. Okay. Pasai Church, please stand up. We want to look at you. Pasai Church, give them a hand. Praise the Lord. I want to know whether I have not identified certain groups. Is there anyone here whom I know? Ayas, man, how can I forget Ayas? All the handsome men from Ayas, please stand up. Wow. Praise God. Same color, same everything. Same spirit. I saw Dr. DeCastro's sister coming in. That's my friend. Please, why don't you wait for us? Praise the Lord. I like that. Hey, how can I miss another sister? Praise the Lord. Is there anybody else whom I'm not recognized? Neighbors, you have to help me. Is there a stranger sitting beside you? Everybody's recognized? If I have left you out, it's purely unintentional. Elder Sam, I want to invite you for a special prayer. Okay. Elder, according to any culture, it is offensive to ask the age to a lady, but not to a man. Can you please tell us, how old are you today?
Today is my birthday today.
Praise God.
26 months. And now I'm already 74.
No,
47.
Can you sing for us,
please? Yes. Actually, I want to call my wife. I'm hardly trembling. Actually, we don't know. Let us see. Help us to be in our hearts and in our minds. Indeed. Thank you, Lord, for the holy angels who are singing us. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Praise you for you formed him. And the hands that formed him in the womb are the very hands that delivered him out of the womb. They are the same hands that saw him through the past years of struggles, trials, difficulties. But today is a testimony that Jesus is the victor in his life. We want to praise you, mighty God, for you are a God who never, never fails. You have proved unto your Son over and over again that it is indeed sweet to trust in Jesus. I thank you, Father, for you are teaching him every day that the Lord is his shepherd. That is all he ever wants. I thank you, Lord, for being faithful unto us. thank you for the blessing for the psalmist to his church, to his community, to his family. We want to very humbly submit unto you this evening and ask that Jesus may fill it completely. Every part and participle of him may rejoice, shout out, and proclaim that God is the supreme owner of the universe. We give him and surrender him to you, Lord, that for the rest of his life, till his very last breath, may he sing and preach to the glory of God. Thank you very much, Father, for watching over your son. Thank you very much for allowing us to celebrate life with him today. We praise you and adore you in Jesus' name. Amen.
I'm very impressed by the Spirit of God to say a very special prayer for all those who celebrated your birthdays from January 1 till date. How many of you have experienced the hand of God from January 1st till today? Will you please stand? If you have seen the hand of God in your life, praise the Lord. All those who saw God's hand, praise the Lord. You see, you're with, wow. This looks like an altar call. Okay, I want to pray for you. Father in heaven, great is thy faithfulness. We give God the glory because you have seen the sons and daughters of yours whom you purchased with your precious blood. Thank you for giving them a new life, new leaf. Thank you for helping them to turn a new page, to write new history. I pray, Father, that the same God who sustained them will continue to sustain them. Lay your hands upon them, Lord. Let every cell and tissue and muscle and fiber and tendon and ligament receive healing in Jesus' name. Touch their organs, revitalize them, empower them, Lord. I pray that God will bless their spouses, their parents, their children, their relatives, their well-wishers. I also beg you, and I pray that you baptize them with double portion of your Holy Spirit. I pray that they will get into a deeper walk, a relationship with you, that your power will be manifest. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Happy birthday, people of God. Okay. We're going to get into our second Bible study. Before that, I'm going to invite my friend Frederick to sing for us a song. Don't miss the lyrics of this song. You will never hear such lyrics anywhere in the world. I can promise that. Listen to the lyrics of this song.
The King of Kings, remember. to adore our Creator. How come we come to church very late, 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 and we want to live earlier? How come we come to church and talk, talk, talk until the end of worship? How come we come to church very late, 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 and we want to live earlier? How come we come to church and talk, talk, talk until the end of worship? The Lord is in His holy temple. Therefore, the air is silent before Him. The Lord is in His holy temple. Therefore, the air in silence before Him. Remember, oh remember, we come to church to praise the King of Kings. Remember, please remember, we come to church to adore our Creator. How come we come to church and chat, chat, chat using our phones and tablets? How come we come to church and sleep, sleep, until the end of worship? How come we come to church and chat, chat, chat using our phones and tablets? How come we come to church?
Study this, may you write this in the innermost recesses of our hearts. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. So I'm just going to recap a little bit of what we studied, and then we will get into it. The Bible says God gave them fringes to have in the borders of the garden, and every time the fringe is supposed to be a ribbon of blue,
And you also saw the significance about blue, that they will look, remember, do, and seek God after their heart. So every time you see the law of God, you should always look, remember, and do. Now, God says, you come into the mountain. God is telling Moses. But he says, you come into the mountain and be there. God is not asking him to come with anything in his hand. God is asking or expecting Moses to come up to the mountaintop empty-handed. And God says, I will be there, and I will be the one to give you the tables of stone, and I will give you a law, and I will give you commandments which I have written. Now, these are very intricate details that you and I need to remember. I will give you tables of stone. I will give you law. I will give you commandments. I have written. What you're supposed to do is you will teach them. That's what we are doing now. A pastor should always teach the law and the commandments. What happened? How many people went up to the foot of the mountain? Any idea? Let's look at the Bible. This is very important. Then went up Moses and Aaron and Nadab and Abihu and 70 of the elders of Israel. Please look at this. What material did God use to write the Ten Commandments? They saw the God of Israel, and there was under his feet as it were a paved work of a sapphire stone. And as it were the body of heaven in its clearness. The question is simple. What is the color of sapphire stone? Gray. Okay. Maybe you got this color.
Blue.
Is there still a feedback? There are some microphones that are very unique, directional.
Yes, I can see this all the time.
So when we go like this, exactly. No. Next time I will use the chocolate chips, please. Sapphire stone. The Bible is clear, as it were the body of heaven. What is the body of heaven's color? Do you know why is the sky blue in color? Why is the sky blue in color? Simply because? Okay. Appreciate all your mumblings, but I'm not sure what you're asking. And upon the nobles of the children of Israel, he laid not his hand. God never laid his hand upon the nobles. They also saw God. They did eat and drink. Can you believe? In the presence of God, there was eating and drinking. Then Moses turned and went down from the mount, and two tables of the testimony were in his hand. The tables were written on both their sides, on the one side and on the other, where they're written, listen to this, work of God, writing was the writing of God, and it was graven upon the tables. Let me just back up a little bit about what we studied. They saw the God of Israel, and there was under his feet as it were a paved work of a sapphire stone. In the whole story, I want you to go home and read Exodus 24, please. Then you will understand. Tonight's assignment is, or tomorrow morning, please take time to read Exodus 24. How this takes us. We will try to find out what is the significance of sapphire stone. Let's go to the Bible. Ezekiel chapter 1. There is a very beautiful song when it comes about the book of Ezekiel. How many of you have been singing that song.
Ezekiel saw the wheel.
Ezekiel saw a
the wheel.
A wheel. A wheel in the middle of a
wheel.
You have never seen that wheel? Let's go to the Bible. And I looked, and behold, a whirlwind came out of the north. Look at this. Cloud, fire, brightness. And out of this came the color of amber. Anybody knows what is the color of amber?
Yellow.
Amber.
Yellow.
Yes. And from this, four living creatures appeared. They had the likeness of a man. Now you need to understand, we are talking about the throne room of God. This is very phenomenal. Everyone had four faces and four wings. How many creatures?
Four.
Let's go back. How many creatures?
Four.
Four. How many faces?
Four.
Four. How many wings?
Four.
Four. But this is the description. Four living creatures, four faces, four wings. They had the face of a man, face of a lion, face of an ox, face of an eagle. Can you try to picture such a kind of a creature? Let's try to do this. Face of a man. There is a man's face. There is a lion's face. There is an ox's face and eagle face. Ox and eagle. Can you imagine? Four creatures. I don't want any of you to miss April 16. Ron, can you please tell us a little bit about where are we meeting on April? I want to ask my manager to explain to us.
April 16.
April 16, we're inviting you all to be with us at Summit Ridge Hotel in the Guideline. We have hired the ballrooms by God's grace. He has provided the means to do it. And so our next prayer session will be April 16, Summit Ridge Hotel in the Guideline.
Thank you so much. For those of you coming from AUB, I have good news. Once you get into a jeepney, you will get down right in front of Summit Ridge. If you can somehow make it there, because 500 people are expected. Already 350 plus have already promised to come there. So we have to go. I want to thank Brother Winman, Brother Rob, Brother DeCastro. We have made about 3-4 trips there. And this is very phenomenal, I have to say this. I was in India. I received an email when I was in India. You have to come and pay an advance of 7,000 pesos immediately. I was really wondering, I was conducting a crusade long time, not in the Philippines. They said, if you don't pay it, you'll be in trouble. I said, Ron, is there any way you can ask money from someone and pay? I will try to get the money right off right now. By God's grace, now God is always so good. He went and spoke to Mr. John. Mr. John, will you please wave to us? Stand up, don't try. Just stand up. I know you're feeling shy. Don't feel shy. Thank you. Shall we give him a hand? I was told that he advanced it, and I said I will try to come and do the advance. By God's grace, they went and paid the money. I was praying, Lord, how am I going to get the money to pay back the advance? So right after I came, there was a very good, handsome man. He came to IS with his family and he gave me a check for 10,000 pesos. Amen?
Yeah.
I was thinking, Lord, how am I going to pay the remainder? As I came home, there was another couple that came to my house and they gave me. I didn't ask for it. I honestly said, I did not ask. I got 10,000. I was praying for. The couple gave me exactly 5,000. God is a mathematician. God specializes in giving. Amen. this meeting. We were not supposed to have the meeting today here until just how many days ago? 2-3 days ago? But the pastor said, no, I'm very impressed to do this. He came here, he paid for this whole meeting. You know, friends, people are inspired by the Spirit of God to study. What a privilege. There is coming a time you're going to have a family. You will go after sea. You will wander from east to the west, north to the south. You will look for pastors. You will look for evangelists. You can have a multi-million dollar. Nobody will teach the gospel to you. Take advantage. Read your Bible today. Very soon, Bibles will be snatched away. Do you know that? Only those who have fortified their mind with truth will stand during Jacob's time of trouble. That time, you cannot open your tablet because you will be in Palawan Hills. You cannot, your smartphones will not operate. You know, where will you get your battery? It all has to be registered here. God has given you something that is so amazing. It is not even equivalent to 128 GB. No, this is a million times sharper. Put all the GB right here. GB, God's Bible. Okay? Let's get it. Let's get it. Likeness of the living creatures. Their appearance was like burning coals of fire. Unlike the appearance of lambs, what happened? My friends, all of a sudden, one wheel came upon the earth with a form. Can you believe? All of a sudden, there is one wheel. Just look at this. Ezekiel saw a wheel. Now, the appearance of the wheel and their work was like the color of a beryl. Anybody can say, what is the color of a beryl? Amber? Okay. Sapphire? Beryl? I appreciate that because adventists are not supposed to buy any kind of stones like this. I appreciate all of them. And their appearance and their work was it as it were a wheel in the middle of a wheel. What happened was there was a wheel. The wheels went by now. When the living creatures were lifted up from the earth, the wheels were lifted up. Now there is coming another song. We studied about amber, sapphire, beryl, but here comes crystal. The likeness of the firmament upon the heads of the living creature was the color of a terrible crystal. What is happening here? The wheels were lifted up over against them. The spirit of the living creature was in the wheel. Now we're going to make it very simple for us. What is the object of this vision? Above the firmament that was over their heads was the likeness. Please listen to this carefully. There was a throne. Do you know God has a throne? Did you know that? What is the color of God's throne? Sapphire stone. The appearance of a sapphire stone, and upon the likeness of the throne was the likeness as the appearance of a man upon it. In other words, the idea is simple. God as a throne. And the throne of God and the appearance of sapphire's throne. What material did God use to write the Ten Commandments? Which means the Ten Commandments were written in the same material that consisted of the throne. Why? God's throne is forever. And His commandment.
Now it came about in the 30th year, in the 4th month, on the 5th day of the month, while I was in the midst of the exile of Egypt.
See how Ezekiel gets this vision. He was walking by the river Cherith. This is Ezekiel. All of a sudden, as he looks up into heaven, he gets a vision. Or whatever he sees is a vision.
And quivering fire. And it had a brightness all around. And out of the midst of it, there was something like the look of electrum out of the midst of the fire. And out of the midst of it, there was the lightness.
Look at the four living creatures.
And this was how they looked. They had the likeness of earthly man. And each one had four faces. And each one of them four wings. And their feet.
Four faces. Always.
The sole of their feet was like the sole of the foot of a calf, and they were clean through the glow of burnished copper. And they were the hands of a man under their wings on their four sides, and the four of them had their faces and their wings. Their wings were joining one to the other. They would not turn when they went. They would go each one straight forward. And as for the likeness of their faces, the four of them had a man's face, with a lion's face right. The four of them had a bull's face on the left. The four of them also had an eagle's face. That is the way their faces were. Their wings were spreading out upward. Each one had two joining to each other, and two were covering their bodies. And they would go, each one, straight forward. Wherever the spirit was inclined to go, they would go. They would not turn as they went. And as for the likeness of the living creatures, their appearance was like burning coals of fire. Something like the appearance of torches was moving back and forth between the living creatures, and the fire was bright. And out of the fire there was lightning going.
See how the Holy Spirit so graphically listed
the creatures, there was a going forth and returning as of the appearance of the lightning. As I kept seeing the living creatures, why look? There was one beyond the earth beside the living creatures, by the four faces of each. As for the appearance of the wheels and their structure, it was like the glow of chrysolite. The four of them had one likeness. And their appearance and their structure were just as when a wheel proved to be in the midst of a wheel. They went, they would go on their four respective sides. They would not turn another way when they went. As for their rims, they had such height. Caused carefulness. And their rims were full of eyes all around the four of them.
Now look at the finishing
line. When the creatures went, the wheels would go beside them. When the living creatures were lifted up from the earth, the wheels would be lifted up. Wherever the spirit inclined to go, they would go. The spirit inclined to go there. And the wheels themselves would be lifted up close alongside them. The spirit of the living creature was in the wheels. When they went, these would go. When they stood still, these would stand still. When they were lifted up from the earth, the wheels would be lifted up close alongside them.
Want to very quickly have a transition here. I'm going to teach you that bachelor's most amazing and fantastic. The law of God. So let's go and find out why are we studying about the law this evening. When God prepared Moses to go to Egypt to deliver God's people, he did not go straight to Pharaoh. He goes straight to the elders. Moses and Aaron went and gathered together all the elders of the children of Israel. Did you know that? He did not go straight to the Pharaoh at once, he said. And then he says, afterward, Moses and Aaron went and told Pharaoh, thus says the Lord God of Israel, let my people go. What is the reason? You will be very happy to know what is the reason why God wanted his people to leave that place.
Look here.
There's only one word. Many people don't understand this concept. Pharaoh said, behold, the people of the land now are many, and he made them, what is the word?
Rest
from their burdens. Why are you making the people rest? Because all these while they did not keep the law, which is keeping the Sabbath. And now all of a sudden he says, no, you are making them rest. My friends, as long as you don't have fringes, as long as you don't have the ribbon of blue, as long as you don't have the law of God, as long as you don't obey the commandments of God, the devil is happy. But the day you start obeying the law of God, especially Sabbath, when you take rest, the devil is not going to be happy with you. Let's quickly go there. Thus says Pharaoh, I will not give you straw. Now you have to go get your straw where you can find it. Before they used to give straw, all they had to do was supposed to make bricks. Now you say, no, I'm increasing your burden two more. What is that doing? You should therefore work, there will be no straw. God says, rest. The devil says, work. Now we want to very quickly go. So what did they do? Pharaoh and his officers started beating up God's people. We're going to very quickly go. What was the only solution? God said, don't worry, I'm going to show my power. God hardened the heart of Pharaoh. They had to take a lamb, put what is called as the hyssop, dip it in the blood, put it on the doorpost side and on top, not down, because you're covered by the blood. And when you enter, you're covered by the blood. Now, what happened? That same night, God delivered all of them. Very quickly, we are going to study about Sabbath. I received a text from one of the members that said, we want to study the significance of Sabbath. I was praying about, Lord, what do you want me to study? I want to praise God for the impression. Let's go to the Bible. As they crossed the Red Sea, we will study Sabbath. God said through Moses, eat that today, for today is a Sabbath to the Lord. Today you will not find it in the field. Referring to the man. Now let us just very quickly go through some of the logistics. People are walking through the wilderness. How many days in a week did the manna fall?
Six.
Six. On which day did it fall twice? You should not say Friday. Because which day?
Six.
Very good. On which day it did not fall? But did people collect during the first 6 days and keep it for the next day? Did some of them do it?
Yes.
What are the two things that happened to those manna that were collected and kept during the weekdays? Number one, the Bible doesn't say spoil. Please tell what the Bible says. It
stand.
Number two,
worms.
It bred worms. What does the mean? Don't live Monday by Sunday's devotion. Do you know why so many of us stink? Because you have not read your Bible today. Don't pick up Wednesday's devotion and try to live till Saturday. You will bring worms. How many portions are you supposed to pick up on preparation day before Sabbath? How many?
Two.
Two. If you're reading one chapter, read two. And on the Sabbath, what did they eat? What did the priest eat on Sabbath, every Sabbath? Enter 12 loaves. The 12 loaves that were kept were changed every Sabbath. How many chapters are you supposed to read on a Saturday? Eat the 12 loaves. Don't pick up fragments. Let's go here. Exodus 20 is the place God wrote the Ten Commandments and God gave the Ten Commandments. does that signify the fact that before Exodus 20, there were no law? Yes or no? Do you think there was law even before Exodus 20?
Yes.
How do you know that? Because there was no written. The law was... Did Abraham obey God's commandments?
Yes.
The Bible says Abraham obeyed. Where is Abraham's story from? Genesis. When is God giving the law? Exodus 20. What does that implicate? The law was given in... The law was given in Garden? Where was it? The law was given in written form in Mount Sinai. Before that, you have to understand what tradition was it? War. Now let's go quickly. Did God make the Sabbath rest only for the Israelites? Let's look at the Bible. Whatever is in Elo, you will read. The Sabbath was not man for the Sabbath. Praise the Lord. Also the sons of the stranger that joined themselves to the
Lord
to serve him and to love the name of the Lord. Now, let me tell you. When did God establish the Sabbath? Let's go to the Bible. Way out there in the Garden of Eden. Thus the heavens and the earth were
finished.
All the host of them. God blessed the seventh day and sanctified it. It's happening right in the Garden of Eden. Because on that day, he had rested from all his work which God created and was made. Let's go to the Bible. What day of the week is the Sabbath? We are studying about God's holy law, which he wrote with his own finger. This is the work of God. He wrote on both the sides of the tables. And on the
seventh day,
God ended his work, which he had made, and he rested on the
Sabbath.
What is the Hebrew word for Sabbath?
Shabbat.
What is the Latin word for Sabbath? In Portuguese? In Tagalog? Sounds very, very familiar, right? That takes us to the next level. Look at this verse. From all his work which he had made, and God rested the
Sabbath
and sanctified it. Okay. How has God demonstrated the importance of his holy Sabbath? This is a Bible study. Let's study. Remember the Sabbath day to, in other words, observance. The Lord
blessed
the Sabbath day and hallowed it. God did three things. Rested, blessed, sanctified. Now, when you say God gave 10 commandments, is it okay if I just get away with one? Whosoever shall break one of the least of these commandments and teach men so. You know, many pastors in many churches have the greatest curse, not human curse. You know why? Because if I do that, I will be called the least. If he shall teach men, I will be the least. But whosoever shall do and teach them, the same shall be called great. I want to be called by God, not least. I want to teach the law of God, commandments of God. What precious two things does God say the Sabbath is a sign of? What are the two things that God says Sabbath is a sign of? Maybe you didn't think about it. It's a sign between me and the children of Israel forever. For in 6 days the Lord made. In other words, this is a sign of creation. Then, this is also another sign. Ezekiel 20:12. I gave them my Sabbaths to be a sign between me and them, that they might know that I am the Lord that sanctifies. One is creator. Another one is the Lord who makes us sanctify. Which day did Jesus keep holy? And he came to Nazareth, Luke's Gospel, chapter 4, verse 16, where he had been brought up, and as his custom. How long do you follow a custom? How long do you follow? 2 weeks? 3 weeks? Junior? Regular? How long have you been following your custom? Always. That's why you're still wearing a tie during summer. Okay, now let's continue here. He went into the synagogue on the Sabbath day and stood up to read. Jesus had a custom, and the custom was he regularly went to the synagogue. Is it your custom to go to church every Sabbath? Make it a custom. Let's go to the Bible. What was Paul's custom regarding the Sabbath? As his custom was, he was used to it. He went in on 3 Sabbaths, reasoned with them out of the scriptures. Let's look at another one. And he reasoned in the synagogue every Sabbath. Praise God. Every Sabbath you're supposed to have Bible studies. Get along. There's 2 or 3 people. Sit down together. Don't talk this and that. Open the Bible. Study the Word of God. There is power. Did the apostles also meet with the Gentiles on the Sabbath? Or was it just a bifurcation? The Gentiles were just outcasts? No, let's look at the Bible. When the Jews were gone out of the synagogue, because the synagogue was the place of worship only for the Jews, the Gentiles could never make it there. That's why every time a Greek was converted to this Jewish faith, they thought that this was Jewish, and always these fellows fell out of grace. The Gentiles besought that these words might be preached to them the next Sabbath. When you preach the word, the Gentiles will ask, please teach us about the Sabbath. Did Jesus intend for his people to keep the Sabbath after he died for their sin? Some people say, all the day Jesus died, everything is nailed to the cross. In that case, Jesus should not have kept the Sabbath after he was resurrected. So look at the logical conclusion or the rationalization based on the Bible. It says, pray ye that your flight be not in the winter, neither on the Sabbath day. Look at what Jesus says. And I saw another angel fly in the midst of heaven, having the everlasting gospel to preach to those who dwell on the earth, to every nation, tribe, tongue, and people, saying with a loud voice, fear God and give glory to him, for the hour of his judgment has come. Now it's important. Worship him who made heaven, earth, sea, and springs of water. If you do not worship him that made heaven and earth, sea, and springs of water, you are not a genuine Christian. What or where do you think is the only place in the Bible that talks about the one who created heaven, earth, sea, and springs of water? What is the only place in the Bible that tells you that there was a creator? Which is the only place? Exodus? Verse 11. What is that? For in 6 days the Lord made heaven and earth and sea and all that in them is wherefore rested on the heaven. Praise God. Does the Bible teach that God's end time people would also keep his 7th day Sabbath holy? This is the truth. This is the fact. The dragon, who is the dragon? The devil, Revelation 12, 9. This dragon was the old, called the, okay. He was angry with, not many women. He was angry with the woman. Look at the definite article. One single woman, the church. The devil is not angry with every church. He's angry only with one church that keeps with the remnant of her seed, which keep the commandments of God. The devil is not angry with every church, any church. He's probably angry only with one church that keeps the commandments of God. Next.
Here is the patience of the saints, here are they that keep
the commandments of God. Blessed are they that do his commandments. You go home, get an NIV Bible, try to look for this. Do you think you will find it? It will be very different. They may have the right to the tree of life. How do you know that you have the right to the tree of life? Where is the tree of life right now? It's in. Where was the tree of life originally? In the. How come the tree of life is no more on this earth? Why? Because after sin, God took it, transported it. The only way that you will have access to the tree of life is only when you do the commandments of God. And you will enter it through the gates into the city. Okay. Will all the same keep the Sabbath in heaven? That's a good question. Where do you think is the answer for? Isaiah 66, 22, 22. For as the new heavens and the new earth which I will make shall remain before me, said the Lord, so shall your seed and your name remain. And it shall come to pass, look at this, from one Sabbath to another shall all flesh come to worship before me, said the Lord. From one Sabbath to another. You're not talking about earth anymore. You're already now renewed. You are transformed. Once you have the metamorphosis, you are transformed and you are in heaven, you will go before God from one Sabbath to another. That's very long. Can we be certain that the present seventh day of the week is the same Sabbath day that Jesus kept all week? How do you think? That day was the preparation of the Sabbath to all. Why do you think on this day I'm speaking about this? What is today observed as around the world? What is it called?
Black Sabbath.
What Saturday?
Black Saturday.
Well, actually, today we are supposed to have a meeting for 1,000 people in Ceylon right now. Right. What is time now? Is it 5 o'clock? 5? It's already 5:27. Wow. I have two more presentations. I don't know when. We'll see. I went to the mayor's office. The mayor's office told me, we want to discourage you not to have the program today. I have made all the arrangements. I put out flyers. I put advertisements, singing groups. Everything was ready. It was a very huge disappointment. I said, why do you do that? He said, today is a Black Saturday. I said, what is Black Saturday? I've never heard of Black Saturday. But that's the Saturday we observe in the Philippines, and we don't encourage any singing. And people will not be happy even to come and attend. I will tell you why. Let's go to the Bible. That day, the day Jesus died, was not Good Friday. Do you find Good Friday in the Bible? Do you call Good Friday when someone dies? Especially when the Savior of the world has died. Let's look at the Bible. This is the Bible rationalization. That day was the preparation. Right after that, the Sabbath drew on. That is today. They returned. This is after Jesus died. They prepared spices and ointments. And they did not come and anoint his body. They rested the Black Sabbath. They rested on the Sabbath day. And according to the mayor's command. No. According to the command. Okay. And upon the first day of the week, they came on the sepulchre. Tell me, what are the 3 days continuously said? What is the first mention? Don't say Friday. Come on. Preparation day. Sabbath day. Followed by first day. First day, what happened? What was the historic event? Resurrection. So first day is resurrection. So before the first day is the Sabbath. So when is the true Sabbath? Seventh day is the Sabbath. If the seventh day is the Sabbath and the first day of the week is the resurrection day and the preparation day is the one that is before the Sabbath day. it concludes to any logical rationalization based on the Bible. Publicly, I have informed. Preparation day, Sabbath day, first day. There's no doubt about that. You go to any dictionary and check what is seventh day. It says Saturday, the seventh day of the week. There is no change in the continuity of the weekly cycle, according to U.S. Naval Observatory, Washington, D.C. You put the seventh day and the first day. Every Sabbath day, the apostles reasoned in the synagogue. Paul, as his custom was, even the Gentiles met on. Does God allow anyone to